Today in Office Mechanics, we're going to have a first look at the latest in OneDrive for Business support, including the long-awaited Mac Sync client, and how you can increasingly use OneDrive for Business on your device of choice with the latest in mobile updates. And if you're an IT professional, we'll show you the latest in manageability, as well as new auditing, reporting, and mobile device management. Also, stay tuned till the end of the show, where we see where all of this is going. Reuben Krippner. So Reuben, what's new in OneDrive for Business?
So 2014 was a big year for OneDrive. We shipped lots of cool new features and of course the announcement about unlimited storage coming in 2015. Mm-hmm. What we're doing is we're broadening the range of devices and platforms that people can use to manage their files. And we heard consistent feedback about the need for a Mac Sync client. So I'm delighted to show this and it's released today.
Great, let's take a look.
So the situation is that at work provides me with a Windows PC, and I want to be able to manage and edit and collaborate on my files. But the first thing that I'm going to do is, this is the file I'm working on, drag that into OneDrive, so that's going to upload and place it into the cloud. But when I get home, my PC is actually a Mac. So in order to set this up, it's really simple. All I need to do is download it from the Microsoft Download Center. Mm-hmm. And once I actually set this up, then what it asks me for is where actually I want to set up the sync folder on my particular machine. So in this case, I'm going to go in and set it up in the documents area. And once I've done that, it will then start syncing those files for me. Right. So if I actually have a look within the Finder, we'll see a OneDrive for Business folder. And you'll start to see all of those files and folders starting to sync, and you'll see them coming in as I work on them. So now I can work on that document or any other document that I want and be fully productive at home when I'm on my Mac or at work when I'm on my Windows PC.
But it's not just about desktop experience, it's also about mobile experience and truly accessing your files from anywhere.
Absolutely. So we've delivered now a new OneDrive app for iOS today that unifies that single experience between personal and business OneDrive in mm-hmm. one app. And we've already delivered that on Windows Phone and Android previously. So now it completes that mobile experience across all devices.
All right, let's take a look.
Fantastic. So the app is available. You can grab that from the App Store today. And you'll see that when I go into the application, I've got all of my files, and you'll see there's that AAA Project Pisces document that I'd synchronized mm-hmm. before. But what I can also do is I can go in, I can actually add files directly from the device, photos, let's say. Mm-hmm. I've got the recycle bin to recover unwanted deleted files. But I can also go in and actually have a look at recent files. So all of the documents I've been working on right. are at my fingertips. And finally, I can also see all of the files that are shared with me, not just the files that I own, but the ones that have been shared with me. So I've got a great experience on the iPad or the iPhone with OneDrive and being able to manage personal and business files in the one experience.
Right, and from an admin perspective, we want to be able to have a management level across corporate files and corporate devices so that you can keep personal data, personal and corporate data on the corporate side and managed, and really separate those two worlds out. There's a lot you can do within Office 365 itself, and let me show you a couple things that we're updating here with the Compliance Center. This is really important stuff. So we've talked about mobile device management in the past, but really to do that, the great thing here is I just have to define a new policy. That's gonna be something similar to what we did in the Exchange Active Sync world, where basically we set up a policy name. I'm gonna leave the defaults there. Look at a few controls here, whether or not we wanna require a password, all the things that we're kind of used to from an Exchange Active Sync perspective. But also we can do some new things like blocking jailbroken or rooted devices. Even beyond that, we have quite a few new controls around whether or not we require an encrypted backup or things that we might want to block in terms of usage of that device. And also there's a bunch of additional controls through PowerShell that you can use there as well. And you can decide what users are targeted for these different policies. So if I just want to apply it to one security group or the entire organization, I can select that as well. And then basically I'm finished. I can set up this policy and that will apply to all the users in my organization.
And this emphasizes how important IT control is and security is as far as Office 365 is concerned. We want to make sure that end users love the solutions that they're working with, but we also want to make sure IT can secure and manage these devices as they need to.
And the great thing is, no matter how that data is accessed, whether it's through OneDrive, PowerPoint, Word, Excel on mobile devices, also through Exchange, email services, we're going to see that, we're going to have that device enroll, and we're going to be able to manage it with these controls.
Absolutely.
But beyond all of that, auditing, something people have asked for a long time. We had some basic reports in the past, but now we have the ability really to track that at the user and at the file level. And what does that mean? Well, now I have the ability to go into auditing, look at SharePoint activity and OneDrive for business activity, and all I have to do is set up a date range. Now, let's say I want to look at all the activities that Reuben's done in the last couple of weeks. So I'll go ahead and do that, and I've got the ability to also look at not just whether you viewed a file, but also whether you've shared files, other activities that I might have done in OneDrive.
I've got nothing to hide, Jeremy. That's all I'll say.
So I'll leave it at all, and then I'm going to browse for a username. In this case, I will look for you, Reuben, and see what you've done. Click OK, and when I hit search, it's going to show all the activities that you've done as a user, because if, for example, you've left the organization, I want to see what you've been working on the last couple of weeks, I can do that right here through the auditing controls. Now, the other way around, let's say there's a file that's leaked out of my organization. I want to see who's been working on that. I can also clear out the names there, and I can add the file name right here in this field to look for file activities against a specific file name and all the users who have touched that. So that way I can audit both on the user side as well as on the file side. So really powerful stuff to be able to audit activities, not only in SharePoint, but also in OneDrive for Business. So a lot of great controls that admins have been asking for a while, but when is all this starting to show up in our tenants?
So these sorts of things, the auditing and reporting, the MDM, you're going to start to see rolling out in the next few months. And this is just the start of a broader range of investments across all kinds of security, compliance, and IT control that are across Office 365, but directly cover OneDrive for Business and SharePoint.
So a lot of highly anticipated features, but where is all of this going?
So our key objective is how we bring together a single experience across the consumer and business OneDrive, allowing people to manage their personal and their business files in one seamless experience. So from a mobility perspective, we've already obviously delivered Windows and Android, and to date, we've had one app for consumer and one app for business on iOS. As you've seen, we've brought that together into one single mobile application.
Right.
So now we've squared away mobility. The next phase, or the next objective for us, is to unify the PC and the Mac. So that is, have one sync client for PC that covers both personal and business, and the same for Mac.
Right.
So that consolidates the desktop. And then finally, we want to drive a unified experience across the browser. So again, I want consistency and a common experience in terms of how I manage my files. Doesn't matter whether it's my personal photos or whether it's my business sales proposals.
And importantly here, we also have a great set of controls in terms of manageability. So things like data loss prevention also extending into OneDrive for Business, and also the encryption that we have across the platform.
Absolutely. So our commitment to security, compliance, IT control is unwavering. We just initially focused around creating a user experience across all devices, platforms, and browsers that people want to use.
Now, where can I get started?
So for the mobile side of the house, you can go to your relevant store and grab those apps. And as far as the Mac Sync client, it'll be available on the Microsoft Download Center today for download. Download it and get started.
And of course, all things OneDrive can be found on the OneDrive blog. For Office Mechanics, tune in Wednesdays at office.com/mechanics. Thank you for watching, and goodbye for now.